work, then hit the deck. Someone's going to win, by heck, on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Hi, thank you. What a nice way to start today. Gene Wood, good to see you. Thank you. And we thank John Trout. Looks like he ran out of lines there. Someone's going to win by heck. But we thank John Trout of Phoenix, Arizona for that opening poem. Thank you, John. Now let's get to the cards. Janice and Bettina, if you will, start loading in two brand new decks of cards and we'll meet our players on Card Sharks. George Cox, our champion. Hi, George. Good to see you again.
Thank you.
Won't you remind us about yourself?
My name is George Cox. I'm from Oakland, California. I'm temporarily unemployed. My major hobbies are reading physiology and anatomy and trying to parlay horses.
Oh. And you won $950 to help with the parlay,
beautiful.
Right?
Beautiful. Yeah. Very good.
I must tell you that I said you looked very distinguished. You looked like a maitre d'. Our producer elevated you. He said you look like a Supreme Court justice.
Thank you, Jim. I appreciate that.
So if you're looking for a job, there may be an opening one of these days.
Maybe so. I'll look.
Good to have you back, George. We're meeting our challenger for the first time. This is Chris Kuba. Hello, Chris. Welcome. Got some friends here with you?
Yeah, looks like it.
Won't you tell us about yourself?
My name is Chris Kuba, originally from Houston, Texas. I'm now going to school at San Diego State University. My major is civil engineering, and I'm minoring in anthropology, and I'm a part-time waitress.
Civil engineering? That sounds like an unusual job for a lady.
Yeah, it is. I'm a minority.
How did you get involved with that?
Well, originally, I thought the male versus female ratio wouldn't be too bad, and I turned out to like the stuff.
Oh, that was a good reason either way. Nice to have you here. Good luck to both of you. Each player has a deck of 52 playing cards, and they cut the cards before we went on the air. Of course, the cards are shuffled, and George, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. Chris, the challenger, the lower cards, the blue cards. Before he can begin calling high-low on the cards, you must win a high-low toss-up question, and we start with a question to you, George. We asked 100 married women, when your husband first proposed marriage to you, did you seriously consider turning him down? How many women said they did consider turning the proposal down?
Well, I think that most women think that the first proposal is a joke anyway, and the guy is not very serious, so I would say 35.
35 thought of turning him down the first time, Chris. Higher or lower?
Well, I think a proposal's a pretty serious thing. I think if someone proposes, they'd think twice. So I think it's going to be higher than that.
Even higher than
I
that.
I think more women would consider turning him down.
All right. If it is higher, Chris, you'll go to the board first. If not, it'll be George. And the actual number of married women who considered turning their husband's marriage proposal down is 21. It's not higher, George. You got it.
Right on.
And George, we'll take a look at your base card, starting with a big eight.
That's a good card.
Great start.
That's a good card. The next card is lower.
Lower than an ace. It is a five.
Okay.
Remember, you can freeze at any time.
Five is not such a good card, but I'm going to go on, and the next card is higher.
Going to risk it. Higher than a five. Oh, it's another five. It's not higher, and you lose both cards. Back to the base card. Chris, that gives you a free chance to play a three.
That's a great card. I'm going to say the next card's going to be higher than the three.
Higher than a three. Yes, for the queen.
The next card's going to be lower than a queen.
Lower than a queen. It is a six.
I'm going to freeze.
She'll freeze. We move the freeze bar over. Can't take those cards away from you. And Janice will fill in the spaces for George. And Chris, the question to you. We asked 100 men. Two of the biggest fads to hit college campuses were swallowing live goldfish and streaking through a crowd of strangers completely nude, in case you've forgotten what streaking was. If you were forced to do one or the other, which one would you choose? How many of those 100 men said if they had to choose, they would swallow the goldfish?
I don't know. We went through a long period of a lot of streaking going on. I think more men would rather streak. I wouldn't want to swallow
so
goldfish.
How many do you think would swallow the goldfish?
I think probably 20 would rather swallow goldfish.
20 would rather swallow goldfish than streak, George.
Well, I kind of go along with her reasons, but I think it's going to be higher.
You say higher?
Yes.
The actual number of men who would swallow goldfish rather than streak is 28. It's higher, George, again. You've got control.
Hang on.
Still looking at an ace. I know you want
to. I'm going to keep the ace, and I'm going to go lower.
Lower than an ace? Yes, with a 10.
I'm going to play the 10, and I'm going to go lower.
And risking it lower than a 10. This time he gets away with a
7. I'm going to freeze.
We've got a tie as George freezes. Each player needs two to win. George, we asked 108th grade students in Wabash, Indiana, who was the first man to walk on the moon? How many 8th graders knew that Neil Armstrong was the first man to walk on the moon?
Well, 8th graders are pretty hip now. What I mean, they've learned a lot by the time they get to the 8th grade. So I'm going to say about 47.
47 knew that Armstrong first walked on the moon, Chris.
8th graders. I don't think that many 8th graders would know that. I really don't. I'm going to say lower.
You say lower.
Right.
And get some agreement with the audience on that. And the actual number of 8th graders who knew that Neil Armstrong was the first man to walk on the moon is 66. Not lower, George.
Right on.
Again, you've got that all-important control. Now, George, you won the question. You have the right to change
the
base card.
May I change the 7, please?
Next card off the top of the deck is a 5. A little better card.
That's a little better card. Okay, I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 5. Yes, with an 8.
I'm going to freeze.
Freezing, needing just one card while Chris needs two, and we are at sudden death. The final question. Someone has to win with this play. Chris, we polled 100 men who are senior citizens and asked them, very simply, have you ever flown in an airplane? How many said yes?
I think quite a few. I think most people have flown in an airplane. I'm going to say 80 people had flown.
80 senior citizen men have flown in an airplane, George.
Again, her reasoning is pretty good, but when you say senior citizens, I'm going to say it's a bit lower.
Lower. The actual number of senior citizens who have flown in an airplane is 96, not lower. Chris, you've got control. Chris, you're looking at a 6. You need 2 cards to win. George needs just 1. Your decision, Chris. Do you want to play it or pass it?
I'm going to take a risk and play it.
You're going to play it.
I would like to change my 6.
Then you can change that 6, and you need both cards. You're playing with a big ace. One mistake, George wins.
That's a great card. I'm going to go lower.
Lower than an ace. Yes, with an 8. Wow, right up the middle. You've got to call it.
I'm going to go with the odds and say lower.
If this is lower, you've won the first game in the best 2 out of 3 match. If it is not, George wins. For the win, yes, it's lower. Chris wins it. Game number 1 and $100 to the challenger. We'll set up for game 2 coming up right after we take time out for this. Game number 1 to the challenger. We'll set up for game 2 with the same 2 decks of cards. And the first question goes to you, George. We asked 100 married men, if your wife grew to be just like her mother, would you want a divorce? How many men said they would want a divorce?
Well, I don't think that too many men are very fond of their mother-in-law, so I think it would be a pretty high number, and I'm going to say 54.
54 would want a divorce. Chris?
Now, I've heard an awful lot about mother-in-laws. I think it's going to be a lot higher than that. I'm going to go higher.
Even higher than that?
Oh, sure.
Well, the actual number of married men who would want a divorce if their wife grew to be just like her mother is 24. Not higher at all, George.
Very good.
Well, your base card, George, is a 3.
I like that. I'm going to keep the 3, and I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 3. Yes, with a 6.
I'm going to continue. I'm going to play the 6, and I'm going to go higher.
He's risking it. Higher than a 6. No, it's a 3. And that's the chance you take back to the base card, giving Chris a chance to play a jack.
Oh, good card. Lower. You're going to go lower.
Lower than a jack. No, it's a king. Couldn't take advantage of it, and we're still at a tie. Both players need 4 cards. Chris, our man on the street, went to a supermarket in Burbank, California, where he asked 100 women, did you buy any junk food today? How many women said yes, they did buy junk food that day?
I sure buy an awful lot of junk food. I think 70 women.
70 bought some junk food, George.
A lot of women, I admit, would buy junk food, but 70 is pretty high. I'm going to say it's lower.
Lower. The actual number of junk food junky women who bought junk food that day is 39. Much lower, George.
Very good.
You've got a 3, George.
I'm going to keep the 3, and I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 3. Yes,
Chris. Very good. Lower.
Lower than an ace. It is a king.
Very good. Another good. Lower.
Lower than a king. Yes, with an 8.
I'm going to freeze then.
Freezing it. Needing 1 card to tie up the match. And question 3 to you, George. We asked 100 women, which do you consider the better compliment, when a man tells you you're beautiful or when a man tells you you're sexy? How many women said they would rather hear a man tell them they're sexy?
That's a hard question. To tell a woman that she's sexy and she's going to... Well, I would say that about 35.
35 would rather hear they're sexy than beautiful, Chris.
I think a lot more women than that would rather hear they're sexy. I might. I'd say higher.
Higher. The actual number of women who would rather hear a man tell them they're sexy is 36 by one. It's higher, Chris. Whoa. Do you want that jack?
I've got to keep that jack. That's a good card, and I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a jack? Yes, with a 10.
I've got to play the 10, and the next card's going to be lower.
Risking that one and this one lower, it is a 6.
I'll freeze.
Freezing it. Chris needs 2 cards. George needs 1, and again, we are at sudden death in a tough match. Chris, we ask 100 people. Have you ever borrowed something from a friend and never returned it? How many people admitted they had?
I've done that quite a few times. I think 40.
40.
Never returned it.
George,
sure.
Higher or lower?
A lot of people does a lot of borrowing, and I'm going to go higher.
Higher than that?
Yes.
The actual number of people who borrowed something from a friend and never returned it is 56. It's higher, George.
Very good.
This time you've got control, George. You need 1 card. Chris needs 2. Do you want to play it or pass it, George?
I would like to have the control of my own destiny, but I'm going to let her... I'm going
All
to
right.
pass it to her.
Chris, you didn't win the question. You must play the 6. You cannot change it. You need both cards.
The next card has got to be higher than a 6.
Higher than a 6? Yes, for the queen.
It's a great card. Lower.
If this is lower, we have a new champion for the win. Chris Kubo wins the championship. Congratulations, Chris. George, you're a nice gentleman. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you
very much. George Cox. Chris, come on down here. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Now you're not mumbling.
Oh, not anymore.
Chris is going to go for the big money with the money cards coming up right after this. Don't go away. Back with our engineering student, Chris Kuba. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Come on up there, Chris. You won $200 in the game at $100 a game. That money is yours to keep. Now with a brand new deck of cards all shuffled and cut, we're going to give you new money to play with. You're going to bet that money. Starting on the bottom line, $200 and 3 cards. Move up to the second level. We give you another $200 of betting money and 3 more cards. Your minimum bet's $50 till you get to that top card, the big bet, where you must bet at least half the money. Let's go. I hope you do well. Chris,
Thank
here's $200
you.
To start with. As in the game, you have a choice of 2 base cards on the bottom line. Remember, you can change the base card when you move up to this level. And again, oh, very importantly, sometimes you can change your base card again when you move up to that big bet. We want to give you every opportunity. Chris, we'll start with a 2.
Oh,
okay.
Good card.
I'll
keep that 2, and I'm going to go higher. $200 higher.
Right away, the whole thing. $200. Higher than a 2? Yes, it is with a 9. Up to $400, Chris, but now you're looking at a 9.
I'm going to bet $300 lower than a 9.
$300. Ooh, you are a gambler, Chris. I hope you're right. $300 lower than a 9? It is with a 5. Wow. $700 and a 5, Chris.
I'm going to bet $400 higher than a 5.
$400 higher than a 5. Yes, with an 8. Oh, and this is one of those times I'm so happy about the change because we're going
to
move that 8 up and give you $200.
I'd like to change it.
You've got $1,300, and now you can change that 8.
I'm going to change that 8.
See if we can improve it. Boy, I'm happy to see this. Make it a goodie. A 2 again. Love that change.
I'm
All right.
Keep that 2. I want to go $1,300 higher.
The whole thing. $1,300 if this is higher than a 2. It is. $2,600 now, Chris, and a 9. Again, you've got a middle card.
I'm going to go $400 higher against the odds.
Going against the odds. You haven't seen a face card yet?
Mm-mm.
Okay, I hope you're right. $400. Let's see a face card now. Higher? No, it's a 3. But you only lost the $400. You still have $2,200, and now you're looking at a great
That's
card.
A great card. I'm going to bet $2,200 that it's higher than a 3.
Everything. $2,200 higher than a 3. Oh, yeah, with a 7. And as we move up the 7, not a very good card. You can change it. Here's the next card. Boy, you've had 2 good changes. I hope you do it again. You're going to play a 10. That's a better card. You must bet at least $2,200, Chris. You have $4,400.
$3,000, that it's lower than a 10.
Well, let's not see a face card now. $3,000. Lower than a 10. $3,000. Bet. Oh, no! But you had a great cushion, Chris, so you finished with $1,400, and that's not too shabby. Come on down here, Chris. Oh, that was a toughie, but you're playing well up to this.
Thank you. I'm so excited.
$1,400 is not too bad.
Not too bad.
We'll meet a new challenger right after this. Back with our champion, Chris Kuba. Gotta ask you one thing, Chris.
Yeah.
You scared me. It worked, but you scared me when you made that big bet on a 9.
I scared myself. I don't know why I did that.
But you got away with it. Ooh, I'm glad that you really made me nervous.
Yeah.
Good. You got good instincts. You're doing well. Hey, Chris, time to defend the title. Let's set up two brand new decks of cards. Janice, and meet our next challenger on Card Sharks. Gary Snyder. Hi, Gary. Good to have you here.
Thank you.
Won't you tell us about yourself?
My name is Gary Snyder, and I came from Charlotte, North Carolina, and I'm out here visiting my folks, planning on staying here in California. I've got a degree in golf course technology, and...
Wait, you got a what?
A degree in golf course technology.
Golf course? Is that like engineering, Chris? What's golf course technology?
Turf management, greenskeeper on a golf course.
Oh, that's terrific. So have you got a job out here yet?
Not yet. I'm still looking.
Well, good. I hope you get one. You look like a golfer, Chris.
Thank you.
Good.
Thank
nice to have you here with us, Gary. Good luck in the match. And you'll play the lower cards, the blue cards. Chris, the champion, the upper cards, the red cards. Chris, now, we found 100 women. We had a poll a little while ago. If you recall, we asked for 100 women who had 10 or more children. Well, we found 100 women with 10 or more children. And that's 1,000 kids.
That's a bunch of kids.
1,000 kids. We asked 100 women who have 10 or more children right now, are you pregnant? How many women with 10 or more children were pregnant?
I think if I had 10 children, I'd want to quit pretty quick. I would say 10.
10?
10.
10 were pregnant again, Gary. Higher or lower?
I think if I had 10 kids, I think they got a good thing going, so I'm going to say just a little bit higher.
Higher than that?
Yes.
Yeah.
I guess once you get in the habit, well, we'll find. The actual number of women with 10 or more children who are pregnant right now is 2. Hit the higher, Chris. 2. Working on that second 1,000. And Chris, your base card is a 5.
I would like to change that, please.
See if we can improve it with a 6. Not a good change. Got to play that one.
I'll go higher than a 6.
Higher than a 6. Yes, with an ace.
I have to play that card. It's going to be lower.
Lower than an ace. It is the 10.
I'm going to take a chance. I'll play my 10. It's going to be lower.
Lower than a 10. Risking both of those cards. Lower. Oh, no, it's not lower. It's an ace. And once again, a 10 did you in there, Chris. So that gives Gary a free chance to play a queen.
Oh, that's a good card. I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a queen. Yes, with a 9.
I'm going to freeze.
Freezing with a 1-card advantage as we fill in the spaces for Chris. And a question to you, Gary. We asked 100 college men who belong to the Sigma Chi fraternity. Have you ever had a date with a married woman? How many fraternity men have had a date with a married woman?
That's a good question. Now, I was in school, and we usually fooled around with the singles. But I'm going to say probably about 30.
We didn't ask you if they fooled around, Gary. We just said if they had a date with them. You say 30.
I would say about 30, though.
30 have had a date with a married woman, Chris.
I'm a little sister for a fraternity, and I know it happens, but I don't think it happens quite that often. I'm going to say it has to be lower.
Lower. Well, the actual number of fraternity men who have had a date with a married woman is 20. It's lower, Chris.
I'd like to change my card, please.
Just didn't even wait till I got over here, right? You want to get rid of that 6 with a jack.
Yeah,
here's
that's
a better card.
Card. Lower.
Lower than a jack. Yes, with a 7.
I got a freeze.
Got a freeze. We got a tie. Each player needs 3 cards. And the next question goes to you, Chris. We asked 100 married men, if your wife were made president of General Motors, would you run it into bankruptcy? How many women said their wives would run General Motors right down the tubes? Quickly now, Chris.
Not many. I think... 15.
Higher or lower, Gary?
I'm going to say lower.
Lower. The actual number of married men who said if their wives were made president of General Motors, they'd run it into bankruptcy is 30. It's not lower. Chris, do you want that 7, Chris?
I'd like to change that card, please.
Changing the 7 to a 3.
It's a great card. Higher than a 3.
Higher than a 3. Yes, a jack.
Lower than a jack.
Lower than a jack. Yes, 10.
I've got to freeze.
You'll freeze it right there. Christie's one card, and we're going to take time out for this commercial message. Just enough time to wish you a good day. See you tomorrow on Car Shark.
One of our polling groups will receive Amana's Touchmatic 2 Radar Range Microwave Oven, featuring an automatic temperature control system that cooks any cut of meat moist and tender made and furnished by Amana. And some of our contestants will receive a Blue Luster Shampooer and new Blue Luster Plus Carpet Shampoo with grease cutters and brighteners to remove ground-in dirt and grime. And Amarok, new decorating accents for the bath in a popular traditional style. Amarok, a leader in fine decorative hardware. And Serta's Perfect Sleep Amat, an exclusive CertaLock foundation, provides firm support where you need it, luxurious comfort where you want it, perfect sleep of ice Serta, and Eureka's new ESP extra suction power vacuum, 50% more power, more beating, brushing and cleaning action, six-way height adjustment furnished by Eureka. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.